anything that's worth for me. Right, today I'm fitting this bracket here so I can bolt the engine down on these two bolts, there's two at the back, and once it's in I can put the the timing cover fits on like that, and there's a lot of other things to do before then, but I've just sorting out which of the bolts I have to put in, making sure I've got the right bolts for the holes, which I've testing them. I've got the gasket, so I'm going to put the gasket on and then bolt this on. So I just need to take these bolts out now so I can put the gasket on and then we'll be away. One of the hardest parts of this rebuild has been keeping the nuts and bolts in order. A lot of them are similar, but sort of like have slightly different lengths. And I suppose I could have individually marked every last one of them, but I'm not that anal, so I didn't. So I'm just kind of feeling my way now, sort of. Slowly testing the bolts, see if they fit, and that's why I've sort of done a dry fit of this plate, just to make sure I've got the right length bolts. I took lots of photographs as I was taking the engine apart, but typically it's always the area I'm confused about that I didn't bother taking a picture of, which is typical. But anyway, and there, that's, have I got all of them? Oh, one left. Oh, here we go. So I'm going to give this face a wipe down and a bit of a rub down, and then get that gasket on. So the gasket fits like that, and then this goes over the top like that. Now I'm not going to put any gasket seal on this because it doesn't require it, and so I'm just going to put it on dry like this and hopefully it'll work. And if it doesn't, I've got an extra gasket to redo it. So we've got this here and this here. Ensures that the gaskets and the thing stays in the correct position when I'm tightening it up. We've got all the other holes around here are for the bolts that go over the top of the timing cover.
Bang!
today we've managed to bolt this plate on. We put the gasket, you might be able to see the gasket. It's not on properly because there's more bolts to go on, but next time I come down, I'm going to lower this whole thing down onto its footings, and it sits about here and similar across there and the corresponding area at the back. Once the oil sumps and gaskets are on, the next thing is this, whatever the hell this thing is. It's in all right condition. It's got some pitting and rusting on it, but I think it's essentially, it works. I've cleaned it up a couple of times over the last 2 years in preparation of putting it back on the engine, but I've not got to that stage yet. So hopefully this is the last time I'll have to polish this thing up before it goes on. So yeah, this is once this is on, then the engine 99% done. Hopefully you can see me. Just returning, going back to the shop to pick up Bev. I've been down the boat, I've been doing a bit, few odd jobs. I just wanted to talk a little bit about the videos and why I'm doing them. I'm averaging about 80, 90 views per video, and I've got like 30 subscribers, which I'm very grateful for. But I never started this with the intention of becoming the kind of YouTuber that gets sponsored on Patreon, like SV Seeker or Finding Simon and Acorn Arabella, which are all people I respect and I speak to sometimes, and I value their input, but I'm not trying to emulate them. What I'm really doing is I'm very goal orientated, you could say. When I was before I became disabled, I was in academia. I was training to be a teacher. I was doing a PhD and all the rest of it, and I always like to have some kind of goal in mind, and it also helps to have some kind of deadline. Anyway, what I found is making these videos is really sort of encouraged me to work a lot faster than I have been, because I've been like noodling about on this boat for 4 years, just sort of, and I think I've done more in the last 6 months than I've done in the last 2 years, which is bizarre because I've been probably the worst health-wise, like disability-wise, in the last 6 months than I have been for about 5 or 6 years. I mean, I stopped using a wheelchair 7 years ago, and I'm started using one again. But anyway, so without the boat, I wouldn't have a reason to leave the house apart from go to work. And even then, I was taking forever to do anything. But so making these videos is really sort of encouraged us to work a lot faster and to do things more regularly, try and sort of get a video out at least once a fortnight or something. So, oh my God. So yeah, I just wanted to say that, and I'm very grateful for any subscribers, but I'm not looking for any financial support or anything. I'm mainly looking for feedback and encouragement, and I've already started to get that in the comments section, which is brilliant, so I'm really chuffed with that. So yeah, so I'm glad, if anybody's watching, I'm glad you're along for the journey. If not, I'm really just addressing this to my future self, and which again is a good thing, because one of the problems I have with my ME is an atrocious short-term memory and a really bad long-term memory. So I kind of, it's good for me to keep this record of what I've been doing. So I wish I'd been doing it from the start, to be honest with you, but there you have it. So yeah, so good to have you along for the ride.